Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Today, and we're back again with some exciting news for you. Let's begin our first news regarding SpaceX stopped catching of rocket components. SpaceX has decided to stop catching rocket elements, especially the payload fairings falling back from the sky, using ships equipped with nets. SpaceX has commissioned two ships, Miss Tree and Miss Chief, installed with massive sky-facing nets to catch the fairing halves as they return from space after a mission. Report says that Miss Tree has successfully caught 7 fairings, while Miss Chief got 2. According to a report, Miss Tree and Miss Chief have been recently decommissioned by SpaceX. Meanwhile, Miss Tree and Miss Chief have completed their month-long decommissioning process. All the equipment both the ships have, such as catching nets, communications equipment, and satellite connections, were removed by SpaceX. According to Musk, SpaceX will only attempt recovery of fairing halves by fishing it out from the ocean. The procedure of catching the fairings failed repeatedly with fewer successes. This process of catching couldn't meet SpaceX's expectations. This process was also risky, and in many instances, the ships couldn't get under the fairings. Net bearing arms were damaged by harsh offshore weather. Once the net of Miss Tree was damaged and the fairings slipped down to the deck, the ships were sent for catching the rocket parts, have to carry out wet recovery operations by deploying additional nets to scoop them out of the water. SpaceX uses parafoil to slow the descent of the fairing halves. This becomes successful, but catching a fairing often was unsuccessful. SpaceX therefore shifted to wet recovery of the fairings by using recovery ships Go Navigator and Go Searcher. SpaceX uses the Go Navigator and Go Searcher specifically for Crew Dragon recovery missions, but they've also recovered 16 payload fairings within the last 2 years. SpaceX has also chartered a large ship named Sheila Bordelon. Sheila Bordelon's 50-ton crane is serving as a temporary replacement for recovering the payload fairings after splashdown. This ship has also recovered fairings used in Starlink V1 L-22 mission. Sheila Bordelon's smaller deck isn't suited for multiple recoveries. It can only hold 2 fairing halves at a time. So, SpaceX has to commission several larger and spacious vessels in its recovery fleet to ensure timely recovery of fairings. Let's take a look over the second update on space competition of the future. On the 8th of April, 2021, the Office of the Director of National Intelligence released a new report, which states that another country is to give tough competition to the United States in every aspect of space very soon. As you can guess, China is that country. It may become another largest and significant rival to the United States in space by 2040. This trend of the future space industry is predicted by the National Intelligence Council. According to a report, the predictions will take shape over the coming 2 decades, creating a situation of a global national security environment. In the report, certain predictions were made. One of them is that by 2040, governments of many countries will regularly carry out assembly and manufacturing activities, on-orbit servicing, advanced autonomy, and additive manufacturing procedures to develop their space technologies. Report also predicts that commercial space service providers will offer on-orbit servicing of satellites like repair, remote survey, relocation, refueling of satellites, and removal of space debris. Satellites operational in orbit can be upgraded, made long-lasting with the help of these on-orbit services. The private sector companies would need government support to grow, states the report. Another prediction from the report is a rapid increase in the number of countries who will join in the space exploration activities by 2040. These countries will gain enormous scientific and technical advancement and achievements, economic benefits, and of course, national prestige. China is already one of the largest space competitors among the space giants. Chinese space services like the Baidu satellite navigation system are already rivaling the global positioning system, and the report says in the future it will be used around the world as an alternative to GPS. The report also shows that China will have more foreign partners participating in Chinese-led space activities by 2040. The released report says AI will allow innovative use of space services by assisting with operation of large satellite constellations and space situational awareness capabilities. At present, artificial intelligence and machine learning are paving the way to analyze large volumes of data rapidly. This section will continue to improve with time and improve space and ground-based systems. Thus, AI will transform the space industry by a lot. The report forecasted that a larger spectrum of space technologies will be available for its use in military, civil, and commercial sectors. By 2040, hold of private entities will be much stronger. The role of commercial entities will expand dramatically. Yet governments will remain the primary source of funding for large-scale space exploration activities. Commercial efforts will further improve the government-funded space programs by assisting them in developing space technologies. Let's move to the next segment of the news based on the cutdown of production costs of Starlink terminals. Gwynne Shotwell, president of SpaceX, said at the LEO Digital Forum virtual panel of 2021 that the Starlink terminal production costs have dropped down nearly half of the earlier production costs. Thus, it seems a cutdown of nearly 50% in the manufacturing cost. Shotwell also pointed out in the LEO Digital Forum that SpaceX had made great progress by reducing the cost of the Starlink user terminal. At the beginning, SpaceX had to spend $3,000 for producing a single unit of Starlink user terminal, but at present they've to spend less than $1,500 per user terminal. Shotwell later said that SpaceX had just rolled out a new version that saved about $200 off the cost. "I don't think we're going to do tiered pricing to consumers. We are going to try to keep it as simple as possible and transparent as possible. So right now, there are no plans for tier to consumers." Elon Musk has earlier pointed to the challenges SpaceX faced with production costs of Starlink user terminals. Musk said that the satellite network connectivity system needs to pass through a deep chasm of negative cash flow to make Starlink financially viable. SpaceX is likely to optimize Starlink's production costs to make it economically viable. This same optimization procedure was followed earlier for the cost efficiency in the Tesla's Model 3 production. Shotwell also discussed intentions of SpaceX regarding service plans for the Starlink internet system. According to Shotwell, SpaceX would keep the pricing policy as simple as possible and to keep services free from complexity. Let's move to our last news regarding SpaceX to give global connectivity with 5 more Starlink launches. On the 6th of April 2021 at Satellite 2021's LEO Digital Forum, Gwynne Shotwell announced that SpaceX expects to reach their target of global connectivity within a couple of months. Shotwell also said that with the completion of the 28th Starlink launch, in total, this target can be achieved. Just one day after Shotwell's panel appearance, SpaceX launched its 490th Starlink satellite of the year, 2021. Shotwell implied that the constellation of satellites could achieve full connectivity within a few months from now. SpaceX will have nearly 1,700 operational satellites in the near future to provide uninterrupted Starlink coverage throughout the world by the end of September this year. Michael Sheets tweeted on the 6th of April, "SpaceX President Shotwell says the company has roughly 1,320 of its version 1.0 Starlink satellites in orbit right now. We hope to have full connectivity globally after about 28 launches." But it's unclear what exactly the SpaceX president and COO meant with that announcement, "full connectivity globally," given that SpaceX will require a significant amount of satellites to give full coverage throughout the Earth. SpaceX's Starlink launch, conducted on the 7th of April, was the 23rd successful launch of operational version 1.0 satellites. Starlink 23 added another 60 satellites in the 250-kilometer orbital path. Out of all the Starlink satellites launched, 900 of them have reached their final destined orbit. 400 satellites are on the way to their final orbital path of 550 kilometers. According to a report, it will take more than 2 or 3 months for them to gear them up to their operational orbit. From the beginning, SpaceX has launched 1,383 operational Starlink satellites in orbit. Out of those total numbers of satellites, some 1,369 satellites are still in their orbital path. Report says that 1,356 are operational at present, providing network connection all around. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.